Now, these are just some of the AI assistants we're working on. Let's start with the mapping assistant in the map viewer. This map contains data from the Living Atlas. Typically, I would start by accessing the Styles tab and choosing a field. But now, I have the mapping assistant. Show high temperatures in red. The assistant will style my data based off a natural language interaction. It looks through our data to find a field that it associates with high temperatures, and it chose the heat wave field. Let's try a little more of a complex request. Show the relationship between droughts and heat waves. The assistant is once again looking for two fields that meet the criteria of our request. The map the assistant created shows the overlap of droughts and heat waves in brown, while areas in blue are more susceptible to droughts, and areas in orange are under threat from heat waves. Generative AI assistants are also coming to ArcGIS Pro. This is every tornado from 1950 to 2020. Let's use the SQL AI assistant to dive a little deeper into this. The assistant asked me a question. How can I help you today? First, I want to connect to my database and point specifically to these two layers. Now, show me the strong tornadoes within Tornado Alley from 1990 to 2020. The assistant will write the SQL for me. Give it a second, it's thinking, and there it is. I can review this SQL before running it and adding it to my map. You'll note that my request asked for strong tornadoes. The large language model powering this assistant was able to infer magnitude from this field and chose to show me anything on the Fujita tornado scale greater than or equal to 3 as a strong tornado. The third assistant I want to share with you is Survey123. For example, when a tornado strikes, we want to be able to deploy a survey to the field. The assistant allows us to quickly generate that survey and get it into the hands of emergency responders. Create a survey responding to tornado damage. The assistant takes our request, generates a draft form, and allows us to complete the survey, saving us time. This is what the final tornado damage assessment would look like. And we could begin to fill it out manually, or we could get some help from our next assistant, computer vision in Survey123. When teams deploy to the field, they typically take pictures like this, and they would use them to answer questions in the survey. But that takes valuable time that we do not always have. So let's get some help from computer vision. By dragging and dropping our image, the assistant will automatically extract information from the photo and answer the questions in our survey for us. Give it a second. It's thinking about it. It's thinking. And there it is. Okay.